Kia ora. Howdy, mate. G'day. How are you today? We're going to tie a Kakahi Queen Nymph today. Tail's going to be off a pheasant rump feather. And the body's going to be made up of peacock hill. The head is going to be built up from uni thread 6 bar 0, and the wing case is going to be turkey feather wing, ribbed with copper wire and weighted with lead. Peacock wheel. And turkey feather. I'm using a Norvice with the fine point jaw adaption. I find that best for tying a lot of my flies, 90% of my flies actually. Just got to get them centered up properly and you're away laughing. Okay. Righto. We'll get a hook in there and away we get. There we go. This nymph is fished on a floating line. Weighted, we need to get it down. It imitates mayfly nymph. Now, our basic colours are bronze and brown. You cast it upstream, let it sink to the bottom, and then just dead drift back. A lot of the time is when you get your strikes, is when you go to lift the fly at the end of the drift to do your retrieve. Your tail's about the length of the hook shank. Yep. We're not going to get too fussy here because it's all bound down with the throat. The bend. The wire I'm using, copper wire, is about 0.3 of a mil. If you ever need to think about imperial, just convert it on the computer, on Google. All right, so we tie this in here, the wire, copper wire for our ribbing. 9 times out of 10, ribbing is more there to protect the material that you're using to tie the body with, like peacock hill. It's pretty delicate stuff. The trout have pretty sharp teeth. If you don't know that already, next time you catch one, shove your finger in your mouth and have a feel. In their mouth and have a feel. Okay, that's a copper wire on. Now we're just going to build the body up with lead. The lead here is about 0.6, just over half a mil thick. You could probably weight this with a bead. Really wanted to. We're going to take this to the front and do a half hitch. Half hitch continuously with the, unfortunately this is the only drawback. And there. And, gives a bit of room at the tail, same as what you do, a bit of room at the tail as well as at the eye. And a bit around here, just cut it off with your fingernail. Do an overlay on the overlay on the lead just to bind it down. Half hitch here just to be safe. And a little bit of glue. Seconds for the glue go off. The iridescence of the peacock hurlers attracts fish, I'd imagine. Half a dozen bits of this peacock hurl, thereabouts. Tear it off with my fingers. There we go. Line it all up at the end there, at the butt, at the tips. We're going to tie it in with the tips first. Get too fussy here because it'll all be covered. You can wrap it, twist it around with the wire, or you can just twist it around with the with the thread, or just wrap it straight on and then cover it with the thread. I prefer to wind it on and then cover it with the thread as I go. 1, 2, 3. Give it a couple with the thread. Go a little bit further than we need to. Wire on now. We'll go the opposite way of the wire. 2, 3, 4. at the moment now, I'm really seriously thinking about buying one of those action cams. Action cam, Sony action camera. Been looking at that and GoPro, Contour. There's so many different things to choose from. Anybody out there sees this video and has sort of got any experience, then give me a yell. But I've been watching it on YouTube. The Sony is actually winning at the moment, because I've had a good history with Sony product. That's what I'm using now. Okay, anyway, let's put the wing case in. With the peacock, with the turkey, about 5mm wide. I'm not going to answer that. Then well, I just settled that phone call out. Nothing worse than that, eh? Right in the middle of when you're doing something like this, but never mind. Such is life. Right, next we're going to put in is our legs, feelers, whatever you want to call them, but we use a cheap Chinese hackle. And we tie this in Parma style. So we tie it on at the back where the head is. Like that. Just tie it on there. Now I'll just build a head up. It's pretty good. We whack the feather and hackle pliers. I'm probably on about my 10th pair of hackle pliers over the years. They seem to last for, 30, 40 sort of feathers, and they start losing their grip. And you can buy expensive ones and you can buy cheap ones. And then, be honest with you, I've had more success with some of the cheaper ones. Truth be known, they're all made in the same place anyway. What happens is a lot of the products these days are made in China, India, Pakistan, Taiwan, Over in those places there, they can label anything. They can label it to what you want. You just tell them what you want on the label, and they'll put it on there for you. And I know that for a fact. Right, what we do now is we just drop some of those off. A bit of a look there. And pull that over, wing case over. Come up and tie that down. Just make sure we've got it looking all right. I'm happy with that. A couple more for luck. One or two in front. And then I'll slip it off. And just build it up. Carefully not to fully eye the hook. And we get our nylon in there. There we go. Slip her off. Don't let the length of those feelers or things put you off, because they'll just swing in the current. Trout won't know the difference of the length anyway. Right, we're using Sally Hansen fingernail polish here for the eye, for the head, sorry. Here we go, Kakahi Queen Nymph, and there's a dry fly that same name. And now we just put what's left of the hackle through the eye. That's it.